Hey, what's up guys, Johnny here. Welcome to my Silver Arena guide. In this video, I tell you guys all you need to know to clear the Silver Arena in less than 15 minutes. So we will start with the build and then we'll look at the strategy for the map. So before we start, I wanna give a huge shout out to Yaki, aka Yatoku on my Discord. He's doing really good in Silver Arena and he helped me with a detailed guide with strategy for each stage. He sent me a video also to explain what he was trying to teach me. So big shout out to you, my friend, it really helped. And we had some very good times today in the Silver Arena. Let's start with the skills. The best setup in my opinion is Supercharger and AM Bomb. Silver Arena is all about clearing the mobs fast, and Supercharger will double your damage for a whole 10 seconds. It will help you kill the big guys super fast. AM Bomb will get rid of the trash mob, so you don't have to worry about all that and focus on the elites. Now for the gear, again, you want to deal as much damage as possible, so you should go with crit damage on the boots if you can, crit damage on the pants, and crit damage on the gloves also. If you have some crit damage shoulders, you should use them. And then for the chest, you should go with whatever you like. I am a big fan of extra health percentage. It's a matter of preference here. Now for the weapons, I know a lot of guys like to go with the sniper rifles. It really helps getting rid of the snipers in the towers on round 1-3-5. Personally, I like to play the machine gun. So let's go with the strategy now. Okay, so this is round 1. Right at the start, you will go left and right to pick up some secondary ammo before the round begins. You got like a bit more than 10 seconds depending on your loading time. So I had time to go left, pick up some ammo, then the right box, and I still got like 2 seconds. The monsters will start spawning. So all the squads should meet at this platform right here where you got the two snipers. I threw an AM bomb right here because there's a lot of trash mobs, but everyone should focus on the elites. There are some twin blades there. So if you form some kind of a triangle there, it assures you that the elites are always turning their back to one of the squad members, so you will get a lot of crits. So here you see this twin blade didn't last long. And then it's a bit risky what I'm doing. My teammates don't like that, but I put my back to the wall, and it's a tip from Yaki. I put my back to the wall, so when they spawn, I got some free crits in the back all the time. What I should say also is on round 1, you got some snipers on the sniper towers. I'll try to get rid of them. But as soon as you're done killing the twin blades, go to the right and there will be some chargers there with some flying red robots or whatever you call that. I don't even remember. But focus on the chargers, okay? The red things, they don't do too much damage. So once you're done, round 1 is already over pretty much. You will see. Again, I put my back to the wall. Chargers spawn in front of me and I get some free crits in the back. So it doesn't take too long. I got something like 4 or 5 chargers and a couple trash mobs, some blade dude, regular blade. My teammates are up there helping with the damage. So end of the round, run around the map, try to get some more secondary ammo because you'll need it for the start of round 2. All right, so start of round 2, the exact same spot I started round 1. There's a lot more elites this time, so you'll need the whole squad to work on these guys. I suggest you get rid of the Crusher first because he can deal more damage and he's a bit annoying. But then same thing, focus on the yellows. There's not much more to do here. There's a couple gray guys. My friend threw AM bomb here, so it's always helpful when the whole squad got AM bomb. So you can focus on the elites and the trash mob will just die to AM bomb. So again, if you get extra ammo on the ground, always try to pick up the secondary ammo, especially if you're using the machine gun. If you're using sniper, you're gonna have to probably use your primary a lot more often. So keep going. You're gonna spend most of the round here killing these yellow elites. And when you'll be done with these elites, you'll turn left and you will see some blink enemies. So then you'll focus on the blink. There you go. They start spawning now. So when you're done with all the yellow stuff, you get rid of the blinkers or blink enemies. And then there will be a razor blade, so all three members should focus on the razor blade. It will be done pretty quick. Then go left, there's a lot of stuff. It's a great spot for AM bomb. Look at all the trash. I can almost ignore all that because the AM bomb will pick it up. So go to that corner, it's the left corner from if you look at the first spot when you start round 1 and 2. So go in the corner, there will be a lot of mobs here spawning right on the corner. That was another quick round. So before the next round starts, just do a quick tour around the map, look for some secondary ammo on the ground and in the chest. Now round three, I go here, it's one step right of where we actually start. My two friends will get rid of the snipers, and it's important here, round three and five, the snipers are void callers, they deal a lot of damage. Here I go supercharge and I spawn kill the decimator charger. So two guys deal with the snipers, one guy should get rid of the decimator chargers. When my friends are done with the snipers, they should come back and help with the trash here, because there's a lot of stuff to kill. As you can see, I'm taking a lot of damage. You can be more careful if you wish, but that's where the action is at the start of round three. So get together, kill the stuff as it spawns. The deal with spawn killing in Silver Arena is you control the map, you avoid the enemies spreading all over the map, and then you have to run around to find them, which is pretty annoying. So if you know where the enemies will spawn, if you try to learn the patterns, you will kill them as they spawn and it will make your runs much faster. So when you're done with this stuff here, go in the corner again. There will be a twin blade and a couple gray enemies. So deal with the twin blade as fast as possible. Then there's another twin blade that will spawn again. You should always focus on the yellows if you communicate with your team members. Now when you're done, there's another one. So again, tag team this guy, get rid of the twin blade ASAP. He's dead, clear the trash, look for some ammo again, because this is the end of the round. So get ready for round four now. So round four, two guys should go at the spot from round one and two, and one guy should go at the spot where I was earlier to get rid of some decimator chargers. So again, I like to get rid of the crusher first. This guy is the most annoying. He deals some pretty good damage. Decimator charger here again. Here I did a pretty bad AM bomb. I was just a bit too quick, because look at all the trash that spawned right after my AM bomb. There's a lot of blinkers, plus a bunch of elites. So if I delayed my AM bomb by like 5 seconds, it would have been a lot easier on us. But again, focus on the big guys first. They are the most dangerous. Near the end of round four, when you're done killing the elites and the trash in this area, there will be two red hammers and one hellstorm. The hellstorm is the most dangerous enemy, but if you all focus on spawn killing the red hammers, you will be done so fast that the hellstorm cannot really get to you. He's still at the other side of the platform. So my best advice is get rid of the red hammers as soon as they spawn, so they're no longer a problem, and then go on the platform and tag team the hellstorm. He's not that dangerous at this spot, but of course if you take too long to kill the red hammers, this guy's gonna come and do some damage to you. He's really dangerous, but if you do it fast, there's no way he's gonna get to you before you're done with the red hammer. So at the round five, there will be again sniper towers. So two guys should focus on killing them ASAP, because they deal a lot of AoE damage. The third player should go back in this corner that you can see on the map. There will be a bunch of red flying things. I did not have a good start here. I activated my supercharge way early. I did get rid of the enemies fast, but it was not necessary that I use a supercharger. I should have kept it for the red elite enemy that will spawn right after these red flying things. So I got exterminator ribbon, which is nice, but it's not the main point. Now here we go, this guy spawn, you have to kill this guy ASAP because he's gonna spawn the final bosses. So razor blade, if you got the right tools, if I had my supercharger here, it would be already dead. So when you kill this red guy, the boss spawn, you will have the blade dancer guy and you will have the Regis guy. So again, if you work together, focus on the blade dancer. If you all work on the blade dancer, it will be done pretty quick. Again, sometimes it's easier said than done, but if you draw aggro on one of the teammates and the other teammates shoot the blade dancer in the back with snipers or supercharge, whatever you have, the blade dancer should not be too much of a problem. The problem is when you have too much stuff in your area and you get stuck in a bunch of enemies. But if you circle around the map, usually it's not so bad. I know a lot of people really hate this enemy. It can kill you, it can do a lot of damage with your spinning move. I don't know what else to say, guys. It's pretty straightforward. Run around the map, try to get aggro on one of the guys. The other guy should try to shoot him in the back or on the head. It's the weak spot. So as you can see here, the health is going down pretty fast. My friend is shooting in the back with the sniper and I'm getting some crit on the head. And there you go. Once you're done with the Blade Dancer, you should focus on the boss. You can ignore the rest of the mobs because once you kill the boss, everything else dies and it's your time to collect the loot. So the strategy from Yaki is one player go here when I am to distract Regis. So try to get him to face you as often as possible. The other two guys should be right in front of you behind the glass thing. There's two glass here when I got teleported, unfortunately. So the other two guys are here. So when he's facing me, my two friends shoot in the back with snipers and it deals a lot of damage. So I try to get Regis to look at me as much as possible. I show my face. I try to dodge when he's trying to grab me. If he's turning around, I will shoot the back. Of course, I want to get some damage to help the team, but the main objective is try to get him to look at you, and if you can't, well, get some damage. Here you can see the health go down super fast. He's looking at me for a whole 3 seconds. My teammates are destroying him in the back. Unfortunately, I couldn't get cover quick enough and I died. We had the untouchables ribbon until that time at the very end, and then my friend Dukan died. It was very bad the end, but we had a great run. So you can see the time here, 13:23. I don't have the crit on my weapon and I was not wearing my crit shoulders in this run. I was wearing my loot shoulders because I'm trying to unlock the perks. So definitely looking to improve this time. But again, it's not a competition about who's gonna clear faster. It's just trying to improve your clear times to make the farming more efficient. Again, if you like this video, hit the thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel, turn on your notifications, and leave me a comment below. I read all the comments and I try to reply as much as possible. So guys, thank you so much for watching. Watch my other videos. I'll see you guys soon.